Snake, are you okay?
I've been better.
How's Mara?
They've got her.
Damn. Snake, the government has decided not to give in to their demands. We're trying to buy some more time.
Come on, Colonel. Why don't you stop playing dumb? I'm sorry about Meryl, but I want the lies to end now.
What are you talking about?
Metal Gear was designed to launch a new type of nuclear warhead, wasn't it? You knew it all along, didn't you? Why did you try to hide it?
I'm sorry.
Can't tell the grunts, huh? You've changed a lot. Metal Gear, secret advanced nuclear weapons research. Does the White House know about this? How deep does it go?
As far as I know, as of yesterday, the President had not been briefed about the Rex Project.
Need to know basis, is that the idea?
These are sensitive times. Even subcritical nuclear tests are causing quite a stir.
Plausible deniability, huh?
Yes. And tomorrow, the President and his Russian counterpart are scheduled to sign the START 3 Accord.
I get it. That's the reason for the deadline.
That's right, Snake. And that's why we can't let this terrorist attack go public.
We still haven't even ratified START 2 or dealt with the issue of TMDs. This has to do with the President's reputation and America's place as the dominant superpower.
So patriotism is your excuse for circumventing the Constitution?
Please, Snake. Just stop them.
Why should I?
Because you're the only one who can.
In that case, tell me the truth about this new type of nuclear warhead.
I told you before, I don't know the details.
I don't believe you. If the situation is so serious, why don't you give in to their demands? Let them have Big Boss's remains.
You see?
Or is there some reason that you can't do that? Something you haven't told me about?
Publicly, the President has been very vocal in his opposition to eugenics experiments. We don't want the existence of the Genome Army to go public.
And that's the only reason? Huh. Hell with you.
I'm sorry.
The corpse of the DARPA chief is lying right here next to me.
Oh, man.
But it's strange. He looks and smells like he's been dead for days. All his blood's been drained out, too.
Drained?
Maybe to slow down decomposition?
I have no idea.
But the chief only died a few hours ago, right?
Right. But he's already started to decompose.
What could it all be about?
Something in his blood that they wanted?
I doubt it. Just the nanomachines in the transmitter.
Did the chief tell them his detonation code?
I'm afraid so. It looks like they've got both codes and are nearly ready to launch.
Damn. Is there any way to prevent it?
It seems that there's some type of emergency override device that can cancel out the detonation code. It's a countermeasure that Arms Tech installed secretly. You have to unlock it with three special card keys.
And where are those keys?
I've got one of them. I don't know where the other two are. Besides, I'm locked up here.
We've got no choice. Forget about the keys. Your top priority now is to destroy Metal Gear itself. Sorry to have to lay it all in your lap, but you're all I've got. Bust out of there and get to the communications tower. Also...
What? Meryl, right?
Yeah.
I'll save her.
Thanks.
Shut up! Shut up! Shut up in there, will ya? Shut up! 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 Shut up in there, will ya? Shut up in there, will ya? Shut up! Shut up in there, will ya? Shut up in there, will ya?
Snake, it's showtime. Ocelot wants you.
Okay, I'll tell you once more. Press the circle button repeatedly to regain your strength. When you've had enough, press the select button to submit. When your life reaches zero, the game is over. There are no continues, my friend. I fought wars in Afghanistan, Mozambique, Eritrea, and Chad. Among the Mujahideen guerrillas, I was known and feared as Shalashaska. I was trained by the Russian GRU. I am not like one of those KGB slugs. To me, this isn't torture. It's a sport.
You're all just a bunch of sadists.
Don't confuse me with those uniformed fools. Well, shall we begin? Okay, here we go. How did you like that? Shall we go again? Enough yet? We're not finished yet. You're a strong man. Well, that's enough for now, I think. We live in a sad age. Imperialism, totalitarianism, perestroika. 20th century Russia has had its share of problems, but at least they had an ideology. Russia today has nothing.
They're struggling between freedom and order, and with that struggle, a new spirit of nationalism has been born.
The boss has a close friend high up in the Russian government. He's currently the head of Spetsnaz. He's agreed to purchase this new nuclear weapons system. The Hind was just a down payment.
So you're in this for money?
I don't need money. I want Russia to be reborn, to lead a brave new world order. Anything.
I'm not a very good talker.
Please. Tell me about yourself.
Myself? That's a tough one.
Any family?
That's not a happy topic for me.
I don't have any family. No. Wait. There was a man who said he was my father.
Where is he?
Dead. By my own hand. Big Boss.
What? Big Boss? I had no idea.
There was no way you could. It happened in Zanzibar 6 years ago. Only Snake and I know the real truth of what happened there.
So, is it true? Was Big Boss really your father?
That's what he said. That's all I know.
And you were able to kill him, knowing that?
Yep.
How?
He wanted it. Besides, some people just need killing.
That's patricide.
Yep. That's the trauma that Mantis was talking about. The one we share in common.
Is that why you left Foxhound?
Let's just say that I needed to be alone for a while, and Alaska was the perfect place.
Snake. I didn't have a real family either. Just a big brother who put me through school. We weren't even blood related, and he was much older than me.
Where is he?
He's dead.
I'm sorry.
Snake, is there a woman in your life?
After you've been through as many wars as me, it's hard to trust anyone.
Friends?
Roy Campbell.
You're still calling me friend?
Is that it?
No. There was another. Frank Yeager.
What?
Big Boss's most trusted lieutenant. And the only member of Foxhound ever to receive the code name Fox. Gray Fox.
I learned a lot from him.
But didn't you try to kill each other?
That's true. We did, in Zanzibar. But it was nothing personal. We were just professionals on opposite sides, that's all.
And you still call yourself friends?
Hard to believe. War is no reason to end a friendship.
That's insane.
I first met him on the battlefield. He was being held a prisoner of outer heaven, but he didn't look like a prisoner to me. He was always so cool and precise. I was still green, and he showed me the ropes.
You knew him well?
No. We never talked about our personal lives. Sort of an unwritten rule. The next time I saw him on the battlefield, we were enemies. We were fighting barehanded in a minefield. I know it sounds strange to most people, but we were just two soldiers doing our jobs. It's like a sport.
Men in their games. You're like wild animals.
You're right. We are animals.
So if you were friends, then how do you explain the ninja's behavior?
I don't know.
It's your genes. They make you predisposed towards violence.
You really like talking about genes, Naomi. Why did you get into genetic research anyway?
I never knew who my parents were, or even what they looked like. I guess I got into genetics because I wanted to figure out why I am the way I am.
So you studied about DNA?
Yeah. I thought if I studied my genetic structure, I'd find out who I really was. I thought that by analyzing a person's genetic information, I could retrieve the blank spots in that person's memory.
Memory is stored in DNA?
We're not sure, but we know that a person's genetic fate is determined just by the sequence of the four bases in their DNA.
So what about my fate? You know my DNA sequence, don't you?
Your fate? I'm sorry, I have no idea.
Of course not. You're a scientist, not a fortune teller.
Captured you.
Hurry, get me out of here.
Let me go. That hurts.
Hurry up.
Is that how you ask a guy a favor? Let me go. Jeez, it's like an animal's cage. Oh, what a smell.
Because of him.
Yeah, it's the DARPA chief.
You don't hurry up and get me out of here. I'll be laying next to him.
Those bastards. This lock won't open with a security card. You need a key like the soldiers carry.
So what are you doing here, then?
I thought you might be hungry. If you need more food, I can bring some more later. Also, I got you this level 6 card. It'll get you out of that torture room. Here, take this, too.
What's this?
It's a handkerchief. I got it from Sniper Wolf.
Why?
I don't know why, but She's nice to me.
Sounds like Stockholm Syndrome to me.
I was taking care of the dogs here. After the terrorists took over, they were planning to shoot all the dogs. But Sniper Wolf stopped them. She even let me feed them when I asked. She likes dogs. She must be a good person. Please don't hurt her.
Wake up, you idiot. She's the one who shot Meryl.
Well, that's all I can do.
They're planning to launch a nuke. I've got to stop them.
Then you have to get past the communications tower.
First, you have to get me out of here.
Come on, I'm trying my best.
That guard's got the key. You'll have to take him out.
Give me a break. I'm no soldier. I can't take anybody out.
You have to.
I'll be killed. Oh, jeez. He's coming back. See you later.
Wait.
What was that?
That was a close one, Snake.
Ocelot, you'll pay for that.